You almost have to remind people, don't you? Hey, look at me. You know, because there's so many fighters and, you know, man, you know, the MMA fans, sports fans in general only really remember the last fight all the time, the last game, right? The last weekend, the last time they saw somebody. And, you know,
every fighter's tugging for every fan's attention. You know, it's, there's a lot of us out there, and so you got to find a way to stick out.
So what are you hearing right now? I don't really look too much at the rankings just because I think they're, for the most part, a pile of crap that, you know, the UFC, they don't really follow the rankings that much. I thought it was just sort of a ploy to make the media feel important. And, all right, you guys can vote. We're still going to book the fights we want to anyway. So, but with that being stated, I'm looking at your division, and, man, there's a hell of a lot of good fighters. You've been on a hell of a run as of late, and I sincerely mean that. And, you know, you should ask Randall Ailman about the story. We watched the fight when you were in Brazil in the hotel room in Vegas, man. We nearly broke the chandeliers when you cashed the ticket at, like, plus 180, man. But you've really been on a hell of a run, and boom, now you're in the top 10. And I was thinking to myself, I'm like, he probably deserves better. But then I'm like, man, there's a lot of good guys in that top 10 right now. You know, you got your Kennedys, your Rockholds, your Musasis, you got your Belfors, your Anderson Silvas. There's a lot of top dudes, but you're right there right now. So your next fight should be against one of these guys, shouldn't it be?
Yeah, I definitely feel like it will be. You know, I don't feel like I'm too far off from a title shot right now. You know, with one or two more wins, I feel I can justify getting a shot. But, yeah, I got to beat one of these top guys. You know, I was kind of hoping to get the winner of Tim Kennedy and Yoel Romero just because, how it would work out. I could probably get on the December card here in Phoenix, actually fight in my home state and not have to leave the country for once.
Yeah, man. Well, you're like an adopted son. They want to kill you before the fight in Brazil, but they seem to like you since you've embraced it, right? Did you get that? Did you get any love after the fact from the Brazilians?
Oh, yeah. Every time I've been down there, all the, you know, the fans and people outside of the stadium have been awesome. One of my favorite places to fight, just like I've said in past interviews, just how the fans really get you pumped for the fight and how enthusiastic they are and loud. It's an awesome experience to fight down there, but yeah, but you know, when you're in that stadium and if you're not from Brazil, you're going to catch a little flack. So
yeah, you want
to worth it, and I would definitely go down there again.
Yeah, that would be awesome. Seeing you in December. You know, I asked you off the top, you know, about the maturity of having a kid and living a more stable lifestyle, helping you out. It also seems to me that you've been really smart, man. Like you fought smart. Nothing drives me crazier when I know a guy is a great wrestler, but he finds himself in stand-up wars all the time, and he sort of gets away from what his original instinct and skills are. I love the way, you know, you've just been fighting smart recently. You know, what does that come? Is this from hours in the gym, with Power MMA, with Aaron and with Ryan and everybody? You know, what do you attribute to the recent success that you've been on, besides the health? Because I know you were never really 100% before. Now you're healthy, but, you know, is it a mental thing? Is it from a breaking down tape in your opponent's type of deal? What do you attribute to the success to, CB?
It's kind of a little bit of everything. You know, I think going through those injuries and having to come back from them and just seeing how, you know, people treat you and fans treat you when you're kind of down and, you know, working back through all that, it just kind of changes everything for you. Getting to be around top athletes, you know, having Chris Weidman come out to our gym here in Gilbert at Power MMA, work out with us, seeing what guys, you know, how those guys work out, being around Ryan Bader, seeing, you know, how hard he works every day. And just, you know, you see what you have to do to get to that top level, and you start living your life, you know, in a different way and training in a different way. I feel we have the right team around us now. Over the past 3 years, you know, we've been trying to get everything dialed in at Power MMA. You know, we have Aaron Simpson as our head coach now. Jose Benavidez, I've been working with a lot on my boxing and stand-up. The ground game, you know, is coming along good. You know, Andre Maricaba, great jiu-jitsu coach. So just all of our guys, you know, are working together. Jason Kamen's strength coach. everyone's contributing to the team. Everyone's working together. So I think that's what's made the difference.
CB Dalloway with us, former Arizona State Sun Devil standout. And, you know, we've only got about a minute left here. So you brought up Ryan Bader. He's got a fight coming up against Ovince St. Preux. An athletic guy, former football player of the Tennessee Volunteers. A guy who, you know, sort of very athletic, but he gets it. You know, he's not just relying on his athleticism. He's becoming a mixed martial artist. Tough matchup for Bader, but a fight that I think Bader can win. What's your quick take on Bader? What can you tell us about how he looks for the fight?
He looks amazing. You know, he didn't take hardly any time off in between, you know, his previous fight and this fight. So he came into camp already looking sharp and just been building on, you know, his past success, working his butt off, and, you know, he's ready to go. I think he's got all the tools to be a world champion. So I think he'll you know, definitely go out and put a good showing against OST. And, you know, he looks ready. He looks really focused right now.
We encourage people to check out cbdalloway.com. You can get all the information. CB is involved in various charities in the Arizona area. Follow him on Twitter as well. CB, it was great to catch up with you, man. I want to do it sooner rather than later, but it's great that we finally got you on the show again. Congratulations on the recent run. Look forward to seeing you throw it down in the cage sooner rather than later, man.
All right, I appreciate it, guys. And anytime you want me on, hit me up. Take care.
Damn right. There's CB Dalloway. Like I said, this guy 4-1 his last five. I thought he beat Tim Boach, but hey, it is what it is. You know, no rear view mirrors, as Joey Odessa always says. But props to CB Dalloway for putting it all together. And man, the guy keeps cashing as an underdog as well. He's not getting the respect from the lines makers, but he's starting to get the respect there right now. And you know, a win against a bona fide name top 10 type of guy would do wonders for CB's career. All right, we'll come back with our videos of the week, including the John Jones Cormier melee, all that and more. MMA Meltdown continues.